stage, dog. And I'm talking about you might have seen him on the east side at a lowrider. You might have seen him on at the Magic Mall. You might have seen him at Pizza Hut. But he's about to be the next to blow. And he's going by the name of Comedian
Send me a text. I got a comment. Who was in the door?
Thank you. I appreciate it.
I get it. Y'all see me holding this sign, though. What's up? Yeah. Listen, I'll say some shit. That was the craziest fucking choice you had to make, man. Ain't that some shit? That was like choosing between AIDS and throat cancer. Like, which one do you want? Like, both of them was fucked up. That's what I'm saying. I had a nigga one time rob me and told me he was gonna beat my ass to the point that I couldn't grow no more or shoot me in the balls. And that was a better choice than that motherfucker right there. That's a better choice than what we had. But it's good. I'll tell you this though. Black vice president, give it up for that. Yeah. Goddamn black. Ain't she Indian and Jamaican, nigga? What? She West Indian? Listen, I don't even know how the fuck Trump ain't out the White House yet. You got a Jamaican vice president. All you gotta do is let that bitch in one time. That's it. Light a blunt for Camilla. Give her some Hennessy, and watch that bitch get his ass right out. Hey, wood boy, what one, bumper clock, rise, fly the fuck out my White House now. That nigga be gone in 2 seconds, I'm telling you right now. You gotta let the bitch loose. You gotta let the bitch loose, that's what I'm saying. And it's fucked up for her to be a vice president, I'll tell you why. Because she got an Indian mama, and she wasn't impressed at all, I know. At all. Indians, they don't give a fuck, she ain't president. She was like, hey, mama. I'm vice president, mama. I don't know my vice president. You're not the president yet, mama, baby. Come to me back, Camilla, when you're the president, baby. Come back. Come back. Right now, you're not the president. You know shit. Being mixed is a motherfucker. It is. You can't tell, but I'm halfway. I know. The only time you can tell is when you look at my credit. You're like, that nigga halfway. Like a motherfucker. That shit says a lot of sevens in there, motherfucker. A lot of sevens. Yes. My daddy is white, he's Italian. Yeah. Italian. So if you ever wonder what it means to be half white and half black, all that means is if I take too many shots, I call the cops on myself. That's all that fucking happens. That's all that happens. It sucks, because the motherfucker's 6'5". I said the motherfucker's 6'5". And my mama 4'10". Somebody had a good night that night, but I'm not gonna ask no questions. That's fucked up. My daddy left my mom, and this joke is for you, the only white man in the crowd. What up, dude? My daddy left my mama, which means that white people do it too. Now, I could have been mad at that every white man after that because of that, right? I could have been really fucked up and prejudiced. And every white man that I ever saw after that, I could have had a problem because my daddy left my mama. But I did, because that's stupid, right? I already had Jim Crow and slavery to be mad at niggas for. You know what I'm saying? They already fucked up. I already got enough reasons to be mad at him. My daddy hated that joke, like mom. He hated that joke. This is the one that he really hated. You know what the difference between Casper the friendly joke, the friendly ghost, and my daddy? Casper friendly. They both was gone. That's what I'm saying. They both was gone. No. Ghost in the motherfucker. Ghost in. I ain't shit. So, getting back, when you're this short as a bitch, I'm gonna tell you why. If you're not 6 feet tall, a woman don't give a fuck about your opinion. You lost every motherfucking argument. Every argument if you're short. You know why? Because even if you win the argument, sooner or later that bitch gotta reach something for you. And she's gonna look at you like you ain't shit, like, mm-hmm. All that shit you was talking, you really want this, don't you? You really want this. You'll never win. They don't give a fuck. Look, listen. I went on a date before and a bitch said the most disrespectful shit ever to me. We sitting down, having dinner, chilling. She said, look, listen, I'm gonna cut the date short. I said, wow, we having a good time. She said, look, I think I got catfish. I said, bitch, what catfish? If fuck you mean, catfish? She said, well, nigga, you sounded tall on the phone. I said, what the fuck? How the fuck you sound tall on the phone, bitch? I'm like, you need to sound 300 pounds on the phone, but here we are. You know what I'm saying? Like, equal rights, motherfucker, equal rights. That's what I'm saying. Equal rights. Shit. Tripping. But hey, look, listen. If you single, y'all fucked up. It is fucked up out there. I am so sorry. I'm glad I'm taking it, and I know, ladies, you're looking at me like, damn, he taking it? Yes, I am. But I'm glad I'm taking it, because it's bullshit out there. The world fucked up. Look, listen, when I was a kid, I used to go out with a chick and ask for an ID. Why? Because she wanted to know she was old enough, right? Now I got to ask for your birth certificate. Because I want to know Juanita used to be Juan, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's bullshit out there. It's fucked up. And real niggas turning out fucked up, too. Remember when Tank said? The young niggas remember when Tank said, he said you gotta suck dick twice to be gay. Nigga, what? What you mean twice? Bitch, as soon as the dick cross your lips, you're at least bisexual. That's what I'm saying. You ain't gotta be gay, but you bi, nigga, you bi. You like that shit. And second of all, when the fuck have you ever shook a nigga's hand and was like, I suck that nigga dick? When the fuck that ever happened? As soon as you had that thought, you was gay to the motherfucker. What you talking about, Tank? It's crazy out here, it's crazy. It's crazy. So I'm glad I'm taking it. I'm glad. It's bullshit. But I'm gonna tell you something about love. Love will fuck you up. Cause we ain't ready for love. I'm talking about that real love. Any couples been here for a long time? Any couples? That they know right there. That's that real love. Real love will fuck you up because we're not conditioned to be in love. We're all raised by usually single parents. So they teach you to be independent, right? Right. And you think that shit is cool. Until you meet a motherfucker that love you enough to do shit for you. But then what you do? Walk around the house hating that shit. She folded up your clothes, looking at like, bitch, I don't even want my clothes like that. Fuck out of here. Fuck you doing. She making rice, she's like, you need to put more water in that. You gonna burn that rice up, you gonna burn that rice up. Talking shit about somebody that love you. But what happened? Little bitch leave for 3 days. You wonder what the fuck happened. My girl left for 3 days, I was wearing socks on my head, nigga. I didn't know what the fuck to do. She came back, I was like, what a waste. I was like, master, please, take me back, master. You give me eats and sleeps. Eats and sleeps. Love will fuck you up. Love will really fuck you up, I swear to God. And what comes out of love is children. And God damn it. My God. My child looks just like me, but she's beautiful. I know. Every time somebody says, oh my God, your daughter's so pretty. So I know she looks just like me, so I'm like, how about me? Are you lying? Bitch, fuck you. It's me with a wig, nigga. It's me with a wig. I swear to God, she stole my face. And she's just like me. She ain't shit, okay? Love her to death, but she ain't shit. She a hustler, all right? I was putting money in her books. I know, you're like, what? Her books is 8 years old, so when people go to school, they eat, and you gotta put money on their books so they can eat. You feel me? Bam. So I put $20 on her books. Teacher called me the next day, somebody, Mrs. Font, that's my real name, don't say it out loud, I got warrants. Mrs. Font. Your daughter is $15 in the red. I said, what the fuck you mean? Nigga, I put $20 in there yesterday. $15 in the red? She said, well, look, I'm gonna tell you what's going on for real, but I'm gonna tell you what's going on. She been selling her snacks. The fuck you mean? Yeah. She buying the snacks for $1 and selling them for 40 cents. I said, what the fuck? This little bitch fucking on my money. So as soon as she came home, I'm like, come here, get your ass up here. Man, I hear you selling snacks. She said, yeah, daddy, I'm making friends. Who the fuck the friends? You cost me money, little bitch. I said, you buying them for $1 and sell them for 40 cents. What the fuck is that? She said, daddy, I got you. I got you. I said, well, you ain't gonna do that shit no more, right? She said, nah, nigga, I'm gonna charge $25.50. I said, damn, bitch, you're right. You're right. You're making me $20 every time you sell a snack. That's my bitch. That's my bitch. But she fucked up. I'll tell you why she fucked up, because she got my sense of humor. Now, I'm gonna tell you some real nigga shit real quick before I tell you a joke. Real nigga shit. Anybody here with daughters? Any man here with daughters? Bet, it's for all y'all. Me, I like to treat my daughter like a real queen. Why? Because if a fuck nigga ever step to her, she know what a fuck nigga look like. And it ain't me. You see what I'm saying? So every Wednesday, I go to my daughter's school and I eat with her. Take her on a little date, make her feel special. Right? That's what you should do. Right now, if you gave my daughter a ride right now, she wouldn't even know how to open the motherfucking door. She'd just stay like this. Waiting for a real nigga to come by. You know what I'm saying? That's that bitch, man. So she in there, chilling. I come in there, I see three cops. I say, shit, I got some shit last week. They might be here for me, you know what I'm talking about? So I step back. They step back and say, hey kids, remember to tell your parents, don't smoke cigarettes. I said, all right, shit, that's for me. My smart ass little daughter go jump up, talk about, my daddy don't smoke no cigarettes. I said, yeah, you're right. She said, he smokes. I said, shit, what that little bitch gonna say next? She said, cigars. I said, okay, good save. We walking back to the little dinner table. She laughing at me the whole fucking time on the hallway. I'm like, what the fuck you laughing at, little chick? She said, daddy, you thought I was gonna say kush, right? You thought I was gonna say kush, right? Nigga! All right, bitch, you just got yourself some joy. She got yourself some joy, man. That's that bitch. I love that bitch. She real. Matter of fact, I was gonna die for myself today, right? And she knew I had a show. So she goes to me, she's like, dad, I know you're feeling down on yourself, and I know you want to be funny tonight. Just know that I love you, and no matter what happens, I'm going to love you for who you are. Yes, I said, damn! Real nigga kid crying for his daughter, so I put it to her right in my eye, you understand? But that's some real shit. I said, baby, I love you. That's the realest shit I ever heard. She said, all right, daddy. She turns around and says, you remember that big screen you bought last week? I just broke that bitch. I said, damn, what? I said, daddy, love me for who I am. Love me for who I am. Got me. That little bitch got me again. I love that chick. She's my favorite. My favorite part of the whole world is that girl. But I'll tell you this. I'll be honest with you. I'm Puerto Rican, right? It's getting tough being a Puerto Rican girl. It's my first one. Anybody had a Puerto Rican girl before? God damn, God bless you. Y'all still here. This bitch is crazy. Listen, I one thing about a Puerto Rican woman, she hates to see you happy. That's her kryptonite. Seeing a nigga happy is the worst thing that can happen to that bitch. She'll wake a nigga up just because he's sleeping too good. I don't know what the fuck happened. You was too peaceful, nigga. You was too peaceful. What the fuck you mean like that? She did that shit one time, wouldn't tell me why she was mad. That's why she got a ring on her finger. She ain't told me to this day. I went to the fucking wedding night, she'll tell her that. Maybe I know what the fuck I put spending 5 G's for. I have no idea, but I love her. I love her to death. But nobody told me the headache that I was gonna get with a Puerto Rican woman. I used to date white girls all my life, okay? And I'll tell you like this: when a white girl tells you to do something, it's a suggestion. When a Puerto Rican girl tells you to do something, it's a fucking clock on that bitch. That is 5 minutes, and that's all you got. By 3 and a half, stat time, nigga, stat time. And them bitches is fast. And that chancleta, nigga, you know what a chancleta is? It's a sandal, nigga. It's boomerang shit. She threw that bitch from 3 rooms away and still hit me in the face, nigga. I was like, what the fuck? He's sitting ass your clip ass. How the fuck you get it there? My mama, Puerto Rican, of course, but she got a green card, so you know, she got the other green card. You know? Boy, I can't stand that ass. She my weed man now. It's some bullshit. I'll tell you what's some bullshit. I'm gonna tell you some bullshit. It's not because of my mama. It's because she don't trust me to pay her on time and shit. Hey, bitch, you raised me. The fuck you mean? She's like, cash at me first. Bitch, what? You know what the most fucked up part is? The host ain't $2 down. Like, you can knock on my door anytime, mama. Fuck. Can't stand that ass. Mm-mm. She sell pens now. She don't even sell blood no more. She sell pens. You ever have one of them shits? A pen? A weed pen? Don't ever try that shit. That's white people shit. I had that shit, I was hot 3 weeks, nigga. I ate all the baby snacks, nigga. She was mad as a motherfucker. She came in the house, she's like, hey, you getting high again, nigga, shit? All my snacks gone. And my PlayStation missing. That was to get some hoes. I bought that. $40 go a long way these days. I didn't just go a long way. Hey, look, it still happens. I just keep going until I catch the bitch that really say yes. You know what I'm saying? I start with 40 and get to 100. If a bitch ain't said yes to 100, I'm going home. I ain't my pockets ain't that deep. You know what I'm saying? That's what I'm trying to say. It's a good time out here, ain't it? Don't you feel good out here? Y'all look good as hell, too. Shit, I look underdressed in the motherfucker right now. Came in a jersey and shit, looking bummy as a motherfucker. Damn. You can tell I sold drugs before. So I did it. Well, I'll tell you this, look, listen. I really came here just to support my mans, tell some jokes. I'm glad that he laughed at my stupid shit. I love y'all. My name is Minnie. If you ever want to follow me, thank you. Thank you. comedy, I do have a show on CW, 2 a.m. in the morning. It's called the They So Crazy Sketch Comedy Show. I'm also Dream City as well. On January 12th, there will be a play, the movie Friday, and I play Craig. So if y'all can come, definitely I'm going to try to kill that role. And yeah. So what? I'm too short to play Craig. Shit, I'm 6'5", put me on my back.